all the right buttons, and yeah, get ready to do this thing. Maybe I should get some more mounted cameras or something, because like some folks have the streaming thing pretty figured out. I would not be one of them. All right, so I just want to, you know, happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. And I want to thank everyone that bid on the auctions this week for Matrix. We donated $300 to help Felix over in the Philippines make food packs for families. They've had a lot of bad stuff just happening over there with the COVID-19 stuff, natural disasters and stuff like that. It's been pretty rough. So I think what he's doing is really, really cool. And so one of the items we did for the auction to help raise that money was sections of this box. So I feel like there's a lot of light bleeding in. It is early afternoon here. There, that's a little bit better. And so Mother's Day. For those of you that don't know, my wife has to eat dairy and gluten-free, and today I tried my hand at sausage and biscuits and sausage, whatever we call it, and she liked it. Used, you know, special flour and cashew milk to do the gravy and the biscuits and whatnot. So here we go. No guest speakers to help add like actual play value to any of the commentary today. So it's just going to be me. So let's see what we've got here. Don, who won black, said he wanted Hotsies. So we need to open up one of those for him. So here's our box. I'm just going to put that off to the side. And let's get going. Do, 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 do. Do, do, do. Do, do, do. All right. All right. So, Jin. So, like Sky Swallower. Event Sentinel. Civic Sky Swallower used to be a really big card back in Ravnica, well, Dissension days. Dissension? Dissension. Like $10, $12 card. Now it's a bulk rare. There we go. Our first mythic, Ur-Rask, the Hidden, in red. Lovely. And a foil Duress. Very nice. Duress was a staple common for a long, long time. They've printed it a lot, so it no longer has that staple card value. That's fine. Anger of the Gods, really good. Very playable and modern. I would think in Pioneer, but I honestly am not sure. It has been too long since I've seen any paper magic. I'm not sure. And for a foil, Aerial Predation. Very cool. I'm just going to throw that one away. Doot, 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 doot. All right. The Mighty Cephalobroker. Tavern Swindler. Knight of Soul Betrayal. Nice. Don should enjoy this. From Kanagawa era, this is... quite the control piece, giving all creatures -1/-1. It is legendary, so you only get one. No purpose to act as menace. Do 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 do. The dogs are being very playful today. If you can hear them bouncing around up there. The ever famous Bogbrew Rich. Doesn't seem like it. And a Blood Gas. Wow, Don's doing pretty good here. That's two very solid black cards. cards back to back, and a claustrophobia foil. Do do do. Do do do. Do do do. Alright, under the Soulfire Flare, we have the Consecrated Sphinx. Very nice for Blue Winter Eric Dunlap, I believe. I move my notes. Yes, Eric Dunlap. So, very good card. And a foil Aether Vial, which also I think goes to Eric Dunlap. Congratulations. This is a huge pack for you. Excellent. Excellent. Well, that got exciting. So, now, my experience is typically two foil rare mythics. Aether Vial is absolutely a huge win. Not sure we're going to be able to top that. Here's a Malfador from, what era was this? Shards, maybe? I don't know. It's a dragon, so maybe it does come from Khan's block. And a foil Blinding Mage. Blinding in the shiny. So, welcome, person who just joined. You just missed an amazing foil. Very exciting. As I'm now finishing up our first column, we've had a couple of really good black cards, Consecrated Sphinx, and a foil Aether Vial. Basilica, Forge Tender, Illusionary Ambusher, so that means the next one is the card for this pack. It is a creature. It's a Hypersonic Dragon. Watch it go away. And a foil Boros Garrison. Very nice. Very nice. That mixed lot of artifacts, lands, and gold cards is getting some good stuff here. You're getting some really good stuff. All right. Gutter Snipe. Carbon Carry Kid. I really enjoy playing cards like this. It reminds me of Wall of Awesomes. Played this one a fair bit. And Ravnica, Day of the Dragons, fun EDH card for sure. It's pretty sweet. It's pretty sweet. And a Bubbling Cauldron for our foil. All right. A non-foil Corpsejack Menace. I think we have a green foil. Magus of the Moon. Very nice. Very nice. And yes, it was a green foil. Praise Vengeance. This box has been pretty solid so far. Your standard sort of handful of Vault Rares, but a lot of the stuff has been actually pretty good. So, Bubbling Cauldron, Stagger Shock is the next one, Condescend, so that means this next card is not a creature, a second Knight of Souls Betrayal, nice, yeah. And a foil Knight of the Reliquary. Eric is really cleaning house on his bibs here. So that's two foil rares so far. Probably not going to see another one. Jace's Phantasm. And a second Urbasa Hidden. Very cool. Very cool. Republican illusory ambusher. The illusions are a thing, but it's also a cat. I did not notice that. And a second Malfur. Is this box just doubling itself? That's a lot of repetition. And we got some more folks joining us in the stream. Hello, everybody. All right. There's a bird token. All right. There we go. Back in focus. And a foil is Enoch Bondkin. Enoch? A-I-N-O-K. Enoch? But that's not why you came here. You came here for a serum powder. This was a hotly contested card when the London Mulligan rule was being first proposed. Does not seem to have really made much of a difference in tournament play. But I remember, like, when it was first put out there, it was a lot of doom. Angel token. All right. We have a red Tormenting Voice foil to go with your double herb ask in magazine. And Jugen, the rising star in green. Cool. I think that might be the first green rare we've opened. All right. Pitch. White of Precinct 6. I like this as a draft card. I think that's pretty good. Does all the right things. And a Genesis Wave. Very cool. Very cool. Duke. Pitch. Another Angel Token. An Abzan Battle Priest. The Outlast Maneuver. Maybe if it was an untap ability rather than a tap ability, because it does say only has a sorcery. So trade that Earth Elemental. What Earth Elemental? You lost me. I do not know. You mean that's like an uncommon on this side, right? I didn't even see it. Nether Shadows are good. Vorinclex, Voice of Hunger. Holy cow. Who won green? Don won green. Very cool. Three green rares in a row here. The Jugen, Genesis Wave, and Vorinclex. Don also won black, so he's got double Night of Souls Betrayal, and he did not get the Foxy Secret Window open. Not yet. I'm sure we have Earth Elementals, but who won red? Oh, wait, Don. You could ask Don. He is picking up the red section of this box. And I'm sure he would probably want to trade, because he does like the black cards. Stagger Shock. Teferi. Nice blue card. Again, Iconic Masters is really very EDH heavy, so that's pretty cool. And a Foil Trumpet Blast. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 left. Doot, doot, doot. And I know Don's not watching currently, because he is probably with his missus and maybe his mom. I'm not sure if he's from the area or not, because it's Mother's Day. A Foil Wrench the Mind. Doot. And a Supreme Verdict. Very cool. All right. speaking of that, I also don't remember seeing much in the way of white rings either. Timberland gun. And a Savage Born Hydra. Doot, doot, doot. 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 Birds. Rakdos Canarium for our foil. So that's our second foil gate. Well, they're not gates, but guild lands. And Glimpse the Unthinkable. Holy cow. So that mixed lot just keeps getting bigger and bigger. Three packs left. A hunting pack. And River of Tears. So that was a thought back from Future Sight. I don't think these actually became a full cycle, but this was a shifted card back in the day. I think we are going to whiff completely on white here. Drop the token. Shriekgeist for a blue foil. Blood Baron. Very cool. Again, more EDH stuff. These master sets are really good for Commander. Last pack. Then we're going to flip through and recap some of this, because I feel some things got super underrepresented. All right, Green Token for Beast, Iona's Judgment, and Foil, and the last rare mythic of this box is Sphinx of Uthan. All right, well, we ended strong, as is normal in blue. So let's take a look and see what we have here. So we've got a Sphinx. It still feels very far away, but the camera isn't. Very. That Supreme Verdict, Savage Born Hydra, Limps, River of Tears, Blood Baron. And a selection of foils. I'll just set off to the side here for a sec. Vorinclex. Genesis Wave in green. Mugen in green. Serum Powder in Artifacts, which is under our mixed lot component. Malfagor 1. Urabrask. A Knight of Soul's Betrayal, which was... we had two of those, ultimately. Knight of the Reliquary. Magus of the Moon. Looks like I didn't throw away all the token cards, yeah. Day of the Dragons. hypersonic dragon and then the second Malfagor. Consecrated Sphinx. Bloodghast, black. Oh, black did fairly well here. Sorry, no Toxins for Tom. Knight of Souls Betrayal. Anger of the Gods in red. There's a second Urbrask. Cynic Sky Swallower. Cards all over the place. Alright, yeah, I think that's everything. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Yeah, yeah. So I was able to pull them all out. From the foils, we got a Duress, I think is good. The Aether Vial is absolutely amazing foil. Really good there. Pardon me. And yeah, I mean, then we've got one. There was a second land. Might have missed it when I was going through quick. No, there we go. And the gate. One of the neat things about the set is there's foils. Yeah, done. Like that Aether Vial, pretty great. Eric did really good. That mix lot really paid out for him. Because he's got the foil vial, the two... Guild lands and foil, a foil Knight of the Reliquary, and Glimpse the Unthinkable, Supreme Verdict, all sorts of goodies sitting in there. And not a single white rare, which to me is kind of remarkable. But red had double Urbrass, an Anger, and a Magus of the Moon, so red was super strong. Blue was solid with Consecrated Sphinx, Day of the Dragons, Teferi. Green looks really good too. Black looks good. White does not look good because it's just simply not present. But yeah. So, all right. Well, thank you very much, everyone. That's the box. I am going to get those parceled out and down to the shop tomorrow. Thank you again, everyone, for your bids. I already sent off $300 to Felix over in the Philippines to help feed people. And this Friday, Ikoria lands. Yes, Don, you have read with that fill in for 25. So thank you again for that. I did see a couple of good red uncommons. And yeah, so we'll get this all sorted out and off to the shop for pickup tomorrow. Or really any time this week, and that's what I know. I'll stop staring at the cards. So thank you for joining, and we will see you soon.